The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A leper came to him and kneeling down begged him and said, "If you wish, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hands, touched the leper and said to him, "I do will it, be made clean." The leprosy left him immediately, and he was made clean. Then warning him sternly, he dismissed him at once. Then he said to him, "See that you tell no one anything, but go, show yourself to the priest, and offer for your cleansing what Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The man went away and began to publicize the whole matter. He spread and reported abroad so that it was impossible for Jesus to enter a town openly. He remained outside in deserted places, and people kept coming to him from everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I hope you are doing well. If you are sick, please stay. Get well. If you are not, please stay well. If you do will it, you can make me clean. And God cleansed the leper. The opposite in the first reading. The people of God, the Israelites, lost the battle, leaving 30,000 foot soldiers dead. Worse, the covenant was captured by their enemy. Why did God allow those things? Sabi nga nung isang nag-message, "Paano ba magdasal, Father? Yung unang baby namin namatay sa sinapupunan ng aking misis. Ngayon yung pangalawa, I think based on the examination, sabi niya parang merong abnormalities. Why do these things happen? Paano ba magdasal?" I simply replied, "We rather ask and not receive than fail to receive because we did not ask." But in spite of asking, there are things that are not given. As I have said yesterday, things were given to you not because it will make you happy. Things will not given to you because it will give you comfort. God has a reason. God has a reason. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, like many stories, sabi nung isa, "Father, sama mo naman kami sa misa. Pasok kami ng maaga ngayon, yung aming branch magsi-celebrate ng aming anniversary. And we are one of the fastest growing branch." Pero yung kwento ng iba, ang tagal na nilang namamayagpag, sabi nga, sa tagumpay ngayon, wala na. Wala na. What happened? I do not know. You know, I love watching Walt Disney movies, especially cartoons. kahit ako lang tumatawa sa loob ng simnihan malakas, ano, wala naman nakakakilala. Bakit gusto ko manood ng ganong sine? Kasi marami siyang mga happy moments. But even cartoon movies, may mga crying moments din. Diba? Nakakahiya nga yun eh. Cartoons na yung pinapanood mo, umiiyak ka pa. Ha? Kasi ganun talaga ang kwento ng buhay, yun ang katotohanan. Sadyang hindi perpekto. Sadyang hindi palaging masaya. Sadyang hindi ka palaging malusog. A good friend of mine is celebrating her birthday today. But, nandun siya, katabi ng nanay niya, kasi not doing well. Kanya-kanyang kwento. Kanya-kanyang kwento. As I always say this, what is happening around you is nothing compared to what is happening inside your heart. And how do you deal with it? How do we deal with it in the eyes of faith? Do you question God? Do you question God? Or perhaps you ask yourself and ask the question, perhaps what is God trying to tell me? Ano kaya tinuturo sa akin ng Diyos dito? Ano kaya tinuturo ng Diyos dito? Punong-puno yung ating mass intentions na mga sana hindi kami positive, sana, puro sana. Pray, Father, that the result will be favorable, will not be positive. Pero alam mo naman ang mga ginawa mo na kalipas na araw. A good bishop text me yesterday, sabi niya, I have COVID. What can you say except be assured of my prayers? Sadyang may mga bagay na kahit gaano ka kaingat, gaano ka madasalin, kahit gaano kalaki ang iyong pananampalataya, marahil, or baka hindi ganun talaga kalaki. Sadyang ang Diyos ay kumikilos sa mga bagay na hindi mo gusto o ayaw mo. Why do God allow these things to happen? That's the good question. Why do God allow these things to happen? You cannot say God will it, but if you allow it, may mga bagay na sadyang hinahayaan ng Diyos. At ang palagi ko diyang halimbawa ay, bakit hinahayaan ng isang ina na madapa ang isang anak na nag-aaral lumakad? Wala namang mabuting ina na gusto ang anak niya mangudgud, madapa. Wala naman. Pero sometimes you let go. You let go and allow your child to develop his own inner strength that he may learn to walk by himself. Sometimes things are allowed to happen that we may grow and develop our inner strength. And you have to be grateful to people who failed to help you. Sometimes you have to be grateful to people who failed to help you because it made you realize that you can do it by yourself. Minsan hinahayaan ng Diyos nang pakiramdam mo ay ikaw lamang, naiwanan ka, para maintindihan mo at makilala mo ang iyong sarili kung gaano ka kalakas at gaano ka katatag. A brother priest shared his struggle because everybody is infected. Perhaps or most people are infected in his parish. Sabi niya, magmimisa na ako, magluluto pa ako kasi may sakit yung cook. Sabi niya, buti na lang may Google. kasi hindi na ako marunong magbukas ng stove. Nasanay na. Nasanay, lumaki daw siya doon sa kahoy. Ano po? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, we thank the Lord for people that refuse to help us sometimes because it made us realize how strong we are. Minsan hinahayaan ng Diyos sa mga bagay na hindi maganda upang makiintindihan mo kung gaano ka pinagpala. And do not forget this, that during exams, teachers are quiet. During exams, teachers are quiet. But please, don't cheat. Tahimik lang ang teacher habang ikaw ay nag-struggle sa iyong exam. Pero kung nag-aral ka, well, kayang-kaya. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.